Hey, what's going on YouTube? It's Nick from NoobKill coming at you with another Madden video today. So guys, we got new content in the game from a program that came out last season as well. And it looks like Versus is making a return to Madden Mobile. If I can remember, one of the only masters I remember from last season, I think it was a Juju Smith-Schuster Versus. And I can't remember if Saquon Barkley got a card as well. I don't even remember, man. But yeah, I remember Versus was a thing back last season and it was not bad. And it looks like it's making a return right here. But look how many 100 overall masters and players we got right here. It's a very, very nice list of all the players. But let's check out what it says. New 100 overall versus masters have arrived. Let the showdown begin. 6 days for the program. Collect 100 versus tokens to unlock a 98 overall non-auctionable daily showdown set. So that's not too bad. I like that. I'll talk about and show you guys what that's all about afterwards. Exchange 4 veterans or phenom showdown players to complete the 100 overall non-auctionable showdown master set. So I'm guessing I'm probably gonna be picking up Travis Kelce for the team. But it looks like, are these guys? Oh no! Wait! No, these guys are auctionable. These guys down here are the non-auctionable players. So those are what we're talking about right there. And then of course collect versus badges, banners, and players for 100 overall versus masters. So there's the showdown master sets, which are these two guys right down here, Keenan Allen and Devin Bush. You guys see Keenan Allen's with 91 speed, 99 catch, 99 catch in traffic, and 97 spectacular catch. I wish it had a lot better speed on that card. I believe you can Madden Max these guys as well. So if you want to do that. Now, one thing to do notice now with these non-auctionable daily non-auctionable showdown master sets, sorry, with Devin Bush and stuff, right? You guys notice that they're 100 overall, non-auctionable with 100 power, guys. Now, why is that a big thing? Is because with the players with 130 power, it costs less Madden Max badges to Madden Max them. And we'll show you guys that afterwards as well. But that being said, looking at the players, like I said, I'm probably going to go for Travis Kelce. I really want to go ahead and try to get like a 2 tight end set. I will probably Madden Max him as well. And he's, of course, West Coast, the best coast. So I cannot be mad about that at all. You guys see his stats. He's got 90 speed, 99 catch, 99 catch in traffic with 97 spectacular catch. Like I said, I'm going to be Madden Maxing him. So everything's going to be at 99. We also got Dontari Poe, who has 80 speed, 99 strength, tackling, block shedding, all at 99. And then he has some other stats at 97, 94 with finesse moves and stuff. So that's not too bad. Then we got Zach Line right here in fullback. Fourth course spread if you guys need a fullback. I'm not sure we've got a fullback in a while. And then he's got himself 87 speed. His carrying's at 99. Run blocks at 95. And impact block is at 99. So very great stats right there. And then of course you got Chase right here, a new center if you want vertical. If you are vertical and you're running, you need a center. Here's one, and you can go into Madden Max him as well. Then we got Landry right here, who's gonna be 100 overall with 88 speed. But of course, guys, I'm guessing a lot of these guys you look at and you're probably gonna Madden Max him. Now, another one I really want to go ahead and possibly get would be Shaquille Griffin right here, and Madden Max a nice 105 overall cornerback. I just don't know how tall this man is. If you guys tell me in the comment section, I'm gonna look it up later. But yeah, I don't know how tall he is. I know that's a big factor now because every player is gonna play the same with 99 stats. But of course, a taller receiver is always a better, or defender, I should say, is always better. Even a taller receiver is better as well. But yeah, those are the masters that we got. That's pretty awesome. Let's go and jump into the event. So I've already played the first four at the bottom and stuff and got a couple of tokens and everything. So you guys see at the top, you got your versus tokens. Now, if you guys go on to play the event, now these do refresh at a different time or something like that. Let me go and click this little one right here. So you guys can see there are different resets, 5:30 p.m., 8:30 p.m., 5:30 and 8:30. But everything has a hard reset at 10:30 a.m. as usual, like we've have seen for the last couple of, what was it called, all decade programs. But let's go ahead and do one that I haven't finished yet. Okay, so we're going to go and unlock that. So if we play this event right here, should be very easy. As always, the events. Now, like I said, I'm going to try to go for Travis Kelce first. I know we're doing a phenom one right here, but we should have did a veteran one just because, man, if we got the ball to pop out right there, that was a big hit stick. That was a big move right there. All right, come on, Vaughn. Come on, Vaughn, get, oh, he got the ball out, but it doesn't matter. He does not get a touchdown. So we stopped him right there. And yeah, once you finish that, you do get a phenom versus badge, or of course the veteran versus badge on every win, I believe. And then, of course, you can open all, and you will be rewarded Team of the Decade players. Now, you're probably thinking, Team of the Decade's over, the field pass is over. That's kind of weird, but you will be using Team of the Decade players inside of the sets right here, guys. Now, of course, what were we talking about, those 98 overall non-auctionable daily showdown sets? These are these two guys right here. So every day, these guys are going to be changing. If we go to rewards, they don't tell us who else is going to be coming, unfortunately. But you guys can see we got Jared Goff and Marcus Williams right here. Now, how do you guys get this? You have to go ahead and get, first to unlock them, you have to get 100 of these versus tokens, right? Once you get 100 versus tokens, you can go ahead and view requirements, and you can put in 2 badges and 100 versus tokens and trade it in for that respected 98 overall 100 power player. Now, I don't know how many Madden Max badges that is, but you guys can see the stats. He could be addition to your team. I'll be definitely using these guys for the no money spent squad, so not too bad. 94 speed, 99 awareness, 97 acceleration, and all that stuff. And then, of course, we go to Jared Goff on the other side. It's basically the same, but instead of Phenom collectibles, you're going to be needing veteran collectibles, because he's with the purple instead of yellow. And then there you go, guys. You guys see his stats: 81 speed, his throw power is at 95, throw actually short is at 99, mid is at 97, and 95 deep. So not too bad throwing stats for Jared Goff right there. And he's, of course, West Coast to Best Coast. And then, of course, you also have this one down here. Now, you guys notice that these events are be costing you regular stamina. It's not no more program stamina or anything like that until we get our next field pass. Let's just go and auto this right here and see what we can get. So we're going to get a total of 75 tokens right there. And then we're going to go open it all and see what we get. Any elites or anything. No players at all. But we do get 3 and 3. So that's not too bad. So let's quickly go through sets, guys. And then I might open up a little bit, a couple of packs. We'll see what it's all about. So here are your Showdown Masters. Now, what do you guys need for them? It is either Phenom or, of course, the veteran players for them. Throw them in there and you get 100 overall player that is non-auctionable, and that's basically what it's about. And then you got your other masters. Now, interesting, guys. So from the 3rd to the 9th, I guess that is gonna be your showdown stuff, but of course the sets are here for longer than 6 days. It says it's gonna be here for 3 weeks, guys. So I take it back. I don't know when the event's going to end, probably in 3 weeks or maybe in 2 weeks, and we have an extra week to go ahead and complete the sets and stuff. But yeah, how to complete the sets: you guys will need 25 respected badges, either Phenom or, of course, veterans. And then you also need 1 versus banner and then 2 specific 95 overall players. So 4, of course, Griffin. You need JoJo and JC Jackson right here, 95 overall. And then, of course, if you guys are going for like one of these guys down here, for Travis Kelce, you do need Danny Amendola and Bradley in that pack. And then you guys see, like, there only is about, like, I think there's like, wait, what? I think there's like four players respectively, because they call it all just mix match. Because Carlos Hyde is there, but he's not in that set. Antoine Bethea, and then Danny Amendola is there. So yeah, I think there's like 4 of 95 overalls. And then, of course, the sets at the bottom here, you guys do your trade-ins. And then, like, let's say if I wanted to do this one right here, we throw that in, and we can throw in 2 90 overalls, 3 85 overalls, and then 4 80 overalls, and then you get yourself a 95 overall player. So yeah, those are kind of the sets. And then, of course, for the banner itself, you do need 85 overall players plus 45 badges for 1 versus banner. So a lot of banners to be collected. Of course, you guys can go ahead and open up packs if you guys would like. There is a starter bundle, which is actually interesting. They actually are asking you straight up for Madden cash, not asking you to buy it, just straight up. So that's kind of cool. I like that little feature, that, or not a feature, just making it so we don't have to put in, if we already have the Madden cash, why not let's just spend it. So there is that right there. There is a showdown pack. Let's go ahead and open up 1 showdown pack, see what we can get in here. So here we go, guys. There's the showdown pack. And you know what, we'll open up the bundle as well, why not let it fly. Here we go, we open up the showdown pack. I need the veterans collectible, but we do get more phenoms there. Now the veteran collectible is gonna give us 400 tokens, 25, or what did I say, the veteran pack, the starter pack, the bundle right here, 25 versus trophies. That's gonna go in any place for either phenoms or veterans badges, I believe. Then you get 180 95 overall vet versus player. You also get a 181. Wow, okay, that's kind of weird. 1111. All right, so here we go, guys. Let's go and open up the starter bundle, the starter pack. So here we go. Thank you for the versus points. Gracias. And you can only do this once. So let's see. Hopefully we get like Danny Amendola or the punter, because that's what I need. So here we go. There's our versus trophies, guys. Moving on to our 93. Okay, we got Sean Lee right there. Trey Boston. And okay, the last card is gonna be our, hopefully it's Danny Amendola the punter. And we get, okay, I'm probably gonna have to sell this guy. We'll see how much he's going on the block. But yeah, those are the packs. There also is coin packs as well, guys. So let's open up a couple, both of them right there. Why not? Let it fly. So open up both of these packs. I wish I got Danny Amendola in that pack, but it's all right. We'll let it be. Okay, we got a lot of veteran badges right there. That's great. That's always great. We need those. We definitely need those. Moving on to the next one. All right. What do you got for me? And you got only, okay, 3 and 3. Okay, that's not too bad. All right, guys. So let's check out, before we end off the video, the 95s, what they're selling for. So 95 to 95. And then we'll go to the bottom and versus. All right. So let's see what we got. So they're selling respectively for about 1 million coins each. So that's not too bad. It looks like someone's trying to sell my guy that we just pulled for 1.1 million, but they have a bid for 700,000. So we can make some coins back and hopefully buy the players we need later on down the road. But I probably would probably wait, guys. My tip to you, wait it out. You don't need to buy the players right away. People are very impatient and want to buy it now. Let them be, let them spend the money. If you don't want to go at, when the event's almost over and you're like kind of short and you know you're gonna be short and you can spend some coins, it'll probably be best to spend it near the end because things will be a little bit cheaper on the market, on the block and stuff like that. It looks like Danny Amendola, there's one for 800K. But like I said, I'm just gonna be patient, wait it out. But yes, guys, that is the versus program. Tell me, guys, what are your thoughts about versus and all that stuff? Which master are you guys going for first? Tell me in the comment section below. I really want to say thank you guys so much for watching. You guys know to tune to for everything Madden Mobile, and that's right here on the channel. Always stay hype, and I'll catch you guys soon. Peace. What's up?